An AEW star wants Sasha Banks to be All Elite, and we look at if Roman Reigns is set to retire from WWE. But first, Bret Hart has discussed the possibility of joining All Elite Wrestling. This past week, the Hitman would speak with Lucha Libre Online, where he was asked about the rumours that he's heading to AEW to manage the AAA and ROH Tag Team Champions, FTR. Hart would reveal that he feels there isn't a lot he can do in wrestling anymore, and that he wants to be remembered as a wrestler, and he would say, "Well, I'm happily retired, I'm a home guy now. There's not a lot I can do in wrestling. People say, what would you do in AEW? What would I do? Referee, manage, be a chairman? I don't want to be remembered that way, I want to be remembered as a wrestler." Bret would go on to admit that he's happy to help younger wrestlers in AEW, and even said that he'd love to be a part of the company in some way, and he added, "I'd be happy to help them a lot, and I know a lot of them. I talk to a lot of them, sometimes by text or on the phone, and people call me up. I always got advice and can always pinpoint little things that can make a difference in a guy's match or something that he's doing. But I'm a guy that likes being home, so they're gonna have to call me on the phone. I wish I could do stuff more easily, but I'm getting a little older now, and it's getting hard for me to keep flying around and doing stuff. So I gotta pick my days that I can do stuff. There are a lot of things I would love to be part of with AEW and what they're doing. I know they got some great wrestlers there, and I have a lot of respect for the organization and all that, but right now I'm happy at home." Despite the interest, it seems that for now, Bret is under contract with WWE in a Legends deal, which prevents him from appearing in AEW. With that said, Hart is set to manage FTR outside of AEW at a big time wrestling show in June, with them set to take on Brian Pillman Jr. and Brock Anderson, who will be managed by fellow WWE Hall of Famer Arn Anderson. But do you want to see Bret the Hitman Hart in AEW somewhere down the line? Let me know in the comments down below. Now let's go to some Impact Wrestling news as we look at the aftermath of this weekend's Under Siege event. On Saturday night, Impact would host their latest pay-per-view from Newport, Kentucky, where 5 championship matches would take place. Only one title change would occur, however, as brand new Impact World Tag Team Champions were crowned in the semi-main event. Violent by Design's Eric Young and Cody Deaner would put their belts on the line against Impact's newest tag team, the Briscoes, as Mark and Jay made their first pay-per-view appearance for the company since 2002. In the end, the brothers would walk away with the titles after Jay Briscoe pinned Deaner for the 1-2-3, with this marking the Briscoes' first ever reign with the belts, and ends Violent by Design's 63-day run. The title win comes after their recent departure from Ring of Honor following the Tony Khan takeover, with it believed that an individual within Warner Media prevented them from being signed under the AEW ROH banner. Their Impact World Tag Team Championship follows their recent loss of their GCW and ROH tag team belts, although they do currently still hold the House of Glory titles, meaning they now have 2 belts around their waist. The Briscoes are no doubt huge signings for Impact Wrestling, and they seem to have the full backing from management as their top tag team. And speaking of Impact Under Siege, a big return took place on the show. Following Taya Valkyrie's successful defense of her AAA Reina de Reina's title against Deonna Purrazzo, the challenger would attack the champion after the match, leading to a moment where the lights went out. Deonna would then be confronted by the returning Mia Yim, who was recently released from her WWE contract in November 2021. This is Yim's first Impact appearance since 2017, with her previously working there under the name of Jade. She now comes back under her real name of Mia Yim. She's perhaps best known for her run as TNA Knockouts champion, as well as her role in the Dollhouse stable alongside Taryn Terrell and Marty Bell, and later Awesome Kong and Rebel. According to Fightful Select, Yim is signed to the company on a 6-month deal, which will see her through to the Bound for Glory pay-per-view in October, with it possible an extension will be signed at a later date. But what do you make of Impact's latest signing? Let me know in the comments down below. Now let's go to some WWE news, where new champions were crowned last night at WrestleMania Backlash. The event would take place from the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island, and despite 6 matches being on the card, the show would surprisingly only see one championship match take place, which was for the WWE SmackDown Women's title, where Charlotte Flair would put her title on the line against her WrestleMania opponent Ronda Rousey, who she defeated just 5 weeks prior. This time, the Rowdy One would come out on top, walking away with her first first ever SmackDown Women's Championship, meaning she has now won both the Raw and SmackDown versions of the belt. According to Fightful's Sean Ross Sapp and Dave Meltzer of the Wrestling Observer Radio, the former champion Charlotte will now be taking some time away from television, with it being believed that she is set to marry her longtime fiancé Andrade Alidolo of AEW. As for new champion Rousey, the returning Lacey Evans looks set to be her first challenger, with a match potentially lined up for WWE's next pay-per-view, Hell in a Cell, on June 5th. Now let's go to our final WrestleMania Backlash story as we look at the top WWE faction who has found itself a new member. The show would see Edge take on AJ Styles in a WrestleMania rematch, with Edge's Judgment Day stablemate Damian Priest banned from ringside. Despite this, Priest would make his way to the aisle, technically not at ringside, causing a distraction before AJ was helped by his newest ally Finn Balor, who took Priest out of the arena. During the match, a masked individual would enter the ring to help Edge pin Styles, reminiscent of their singles match at WrestleMania in April. This time, Edge's new disciple revealed themselves to be former NXT and Raw Women's Champion Rhea Ripley, becoming the third member of the Judgment Day faction. Interestingly, WWE superstar Liv Morgan would respond to her former tag team partner's actions by simply writing "what a bitch" on Twitter, before later posting a photo of her throwing up a too sweet whilst wearing an NWO shirt, likely a reference to Styles and Balor's Bullet Club past. Could this be a sign that Morgan is set to join up with Balor and Styles in a new faction to even the odds? Let me know in the comments down below. Next up, an AEW star wants Sasha Banks to be All Elite. Team Taz's Ricky Starks would speak on the Pro Wrestling Illustrated podcast this week, where he was asked about his time in AEW under the tutelage of the human suplex machine Taz. Starks would open up about his relationship with his current manager, revealing how much he's helped him as a performer. He would say, "The relationship that he and I have is that I don't necessarily always have to go to him to ask him for advice. There are times where he'll come to me and say to keep this in mind or do this or do that. I definitely think he's helped me out when it comes to my matches and things of that nature. Then when it came to the promos, we collaborated quite a bit. I don't think people realize that, so I like that about Taz. He sees the positives and he tries to accentuate the positives with me. There are bad things that I do that he nipped in the bud and I'd never do it again, so the relationship is really good, I think." Starks would then be asked who we'd like to see join Team Taz in the future, with him opting to choose a wrestler from WWE rather than AEW, and he would respond, "I mean, if I had to pick anyone to be in Team Taz, it'd probably be Sasha Banks. Yeah, but I think for right now, I like it how it is. I like the fact that it's this small group. I don't want to overpopulate it and then it becomes something boring and just corny. Most importantly, I just don't want it to get to that, but I think for right now, it's good how we have it. We all seemingly found our groove a bit, and this is the best version of Team Taz in my head by far." This Wednesday on AEW Dynamite, Ricky Starks is set to defend his FTW Championship against AEW Tag Team Champion Jungle Boy, and if the Absolute One can pull off the victory, it will result in a tag team title shot alongside stablemate Powerhouse Hobbs. With that said, who would you like to see join the potential next AEW Tag Team Champions in Team Taz? And should Sasha Banks jump to AEW to bring boss time to the group? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And finally, we look at whether Roman Reigns is set to retire from WWE. This weekend, the Tribal Chief would get the internet talking when he cut a cryptic promo at a WWE live event in Trenton, New Jersey, where he told the fans that he may not be back to their town again. And he would say, "I've been here a couple of times over the past 10 years. I'm starting to work into a new phase in my career, and I honestly don't know if I'll be back here again. If that's the case, I just want to say thank you for all these years of support." This, of course, has led to speculation that Roman is set to wind down his time in WWE, with him potentially on his final stretch with the company, perhaps setting up a career in Hollywood alongside his cousin, The Rock. Well, we now have a few updates that have seemingly clarified his situation. First up, we have a report from Fightful that reveals the backstage reaction to the promo. According to the report, Roman is heavily figured into creative plans going forward and is not expected to leave anytime soon, this according to a source within the company. Since his appearance in the Hobbs and Shaw movie alongside The Rock, which was released in 2019, it was expected internally that Roman would begin to take up more movie roles. However, staff within the company have not been informed of any scheduled time off right now. Another WWE source stated that they expect the promo is hinting at a lighter house show schedule rather than a complete exit, which was backed up by an additional report from Dave Meltzer on Wrestling Observer Radio. According to Dave, Reigns has in fact signed a brand new deal with WWE that sees him working less dates going forward, which explains the farewell at the recent Trenton event. Whether or not Roman Reigns will use his additional free time to continue his transition into the movie business remains to be seen. However, it appears that he will be in WWE's plans for the foreseeable future. And before you go, make sure you check out the 12 most obscure WWE appearances from AEW wrestlers.